And good evening, I'm Erin Burnett. Welcome to a special edition of Outfront. We are live from Las Vegas tonight, where in just over an hour, the 2020 candidates will take the stage for what could be the most contentious face-off to date. Bernie Sanders, who is the clear front-runner heading into tonight, already fixing for a fight with the newcomer, Michael Bloomberg. As for Bloomberg, tonight is a defining moment for his campaign. It matters a lot. It is his debut on the debate stage. Up until now, he has used his fortune to blanket the airwaves with hundreds of millions of dollars in ads. He did not even compete in the first four contests, including Nevada. And there are now a lot of questions about his record that he will answer. Jeff Zeleny is out front live in Las Vegas for us. And Jeff, Bloomberg is sure to be a big target tonight.
Erin, there's no question that he is. And until now, he has been campaigning in a vacuum, quite literally, on his terms across the country, using his fortune of nearly $500,000 in television advertising. All of that ends tonight as he leaves his entourage behind and steps onto that debate stage. All of his Democratic rivals say one thing is clear: he needs to be vetted.
Bernie Sanders and Michael Bloomberg on a collision course tonight in Las Vegas.
Mr. Bloomberg has every right in the world to run for president, but I don't think he has the right to buy this election.
It may be the ninth Democratic presidential debate, but it's a whole new political world. As Bloomberg makes his debut on the stage, Sanders is now the clear frontrunner in the primary. Tonight, a new CNN poll of polls shows Sanders with a commanding lead in the race at 28%, overtaking Joe Biden as the longtime Democratic leader. Now, Biden, Bloomberg, and the rest of the field are trailing behind. Ordinarily, that would put Sanders in the direct line of fire.
And yes, I think you should show how you're going to pay for things, Bernie.
But this race is no ordinary one. And Democratic rivals are racing to confront Bloomberg, who's using his vast personal fortune to bypass a close-up look from voters in the first four contests in hopes of raking in delegates in big states starting on Super Tuesday.
Do you think Michael Bloomberg is trying to buy the Democratic nomination for president?
Yes. Yes. I mean, what else do you call it?
I don't think that when people look at Donald Trump, they automatically say, can we get someone richer? I just don't think that's what they say.
Before the debate, Biden welcoming Bloomberg to the stage, saying, we have a lot to catch up on about Barack Obama's record. Bloomberg has risen to the field's top tier by spending more than $400 million in television and digital advertising, presenting himself as a partner of Obama's in the White House.
Mayor Bloomberg and President Obama worked together.
It's been 11 years since Bloomberg was on a debate stage, then running for a third term as mayor of New York. Tonight, the lights are far brighter on the Las Vegas Strip. For his part, Sanders also facing questions over his decision not to release his full medical records, despite suffering a heart attack last year.
I think we have released a detailed report, and I'm comfortable with what we have done.
Just to be clear, you don't plan to release any more records?
I don't think we will, no.
The question of health prompted an unusual back and forth between aides to Sanders and Bloomberg, both of whom are 78. On CNN's New Day, a Sanders spokeswoman distorted Bloomberg's health record, suggesting he had a heart attack. She later said she misspoke. 20 years ago, Bloomberg did have a stent placed for a blocked artery, not a heart attack. His campaign manager blasted the claim as an absolute lie.
On any other debate night, Erin, Bernie Sanders would be front and center, and all the targets would be on his back. But this is no ordinary debate night. These Democratic rivals are trying to keep Bloomberg from rising in the polls. Now, I am told he will be standing next to Elizabeth Warren at the end of the stage. So the dynamic here will be so important for this two-hour debate. He's been on the ground here since last night, practicing with aides and advisors. I am told that they have been throwing out all these attacks at him to see how he responds. But of course, until he gets on that debate stage, standing all alone, it's anyone's guess. Erin?
It's true. It's true until you're actually there in that moment. All right. Thank you very much, Jeff Zeleny. And out front now, Jane Sanders, who, of course, is married to Bernie Sanders. You've been out on the trail every single place. So this is the first debate where, I mean, Bernie Sanders is undeniably the front runner. And I mean, undeniably, we're talking, double digits above anyone else. What is his mindset right now?
It's the same as it's always been. It's basically he wants to talk about the issues that affect the working class of America. And that is, you know, and he just doesn't think about whether he's a front runner or behind. He thinks he tries to be a champion for the people.
So it is about 1 year. It is exactly 1 year since, I'm sure you remember every single 1 year since Bernie Sanders said he was going to be running for president.
Yes. Yeah.
So the polls, though, and during that time, Joe Biden has been the front runner in every national poll, pretty much.
Yeah.
Okay. But just the past week, Mm-hmm. You go. All of a sudden, he's leapfrogging everybody. We just showed 28%. The next closest is at 16 or 15. You know, specifically Joe Biden, well ahead of Joe Biden. Why do you think that is, Jane?
Well, I think that what happened was at the beginning of this campaign, I think people thought back to 2016 and thought, well, those ideas weren't accessible. They weren't realistic. And so then they watched each candidate, every candidate that seemed to be rising to the top and getting all the attention, talking about the same issues that Bernie was talking about, whether it's universal health care or Medicare for all, or free college tuition at public colleges and universities, or the $15 minimum wage. And I think they started to realize, wait a minute, maybe those ideas weren't seen as realistic in 2016, but they are driving the conversation now in 2020. Yeah. And so then they began to say, wait, we need to give Bernie another look. And I think you've seen, he climbed very steadily as more and more people got to know him. He did town meeting after town meeting after town meeting. As you know, he has the most aggressive schedule of any of the candidates. So he's just working hard and winning votes. You earn them one by one.
So he has been keeping this aggressive schedule, of course, even after, you know, he had his heart attack. And I remember that day when you were standing outside your home a few days afterwards when he had come home. And he said, well, maybe the nature of his campaign would change. And there were a lot of people who would have thought Bernie Sanders wouldn't be in this campaign right now. But he's the front runner. So this exchange between him and Anderson Cooper last night is getting a lot of attention. Here it is, Jane.
I think we have released a detailed report, and I'm comfortable with what we have done.
Just to be clear, you don't plan to release any more records?
I don't think we will, no.
Now, when I've interviewed your husband, he's been very clear. He thinks questions about his age and about his health are fair, right?
Yeah,
he's not trying to say they're not fair questions. Do you think voters deserve more information?
I think they've got all the information. Sanjay Gupta just put out a statement on CNN saying that all the three doctor's letters, he didn't just have one, he had one cardiologist, one rehab cardiologist, and the attending physician of the United States Congress, who's been his doctor for 29 years. And he told him the entire health history of Bernie, which is very small because he's always been healthy. He's an athlete. And we also put out, after he had his heart attack, the very specific about what happened. So there's nothing new to be said, and we're really glad that Dr. Gupta, who knows about these things, said, yeah, those letters are all the relevant information.
So today, President Trump spoke to a group of supporters at his hotel in Las Vegas. He comes usually to the state where the Democrats are having their debate to do his rallies. He brought up your husband, as he has been doing a lot lately, and here is what he said.
But right now, he's got a pretty good lead. But it looks like the DNC is going to do the same thing as they did last time. So we'll see if that happens or not. It's going to be a lot of anger.
I think what he's trying to do is sow division, just like he does in the country. What he wants to do is start conflict. So he sounds like he's really taking Bernie's side against the big, bad DNC. We're fine. The DNC and Bernie are fine, and
So when the president is trying to imply things are rigged and they're going to steal it again from you, Bernie, these are the way he speaks. You don't buy into that.
No, we will trust and verify. We'll monitor, and I think we're having in Iowa, we're having the re-canvassing that we did, and he won the popular vote in Iowa. He won the entire primary in New Hampshire. And we expect to do well in Nevada and in South Carolina. And the DNC is being the DNC hosting the primaries.
So there's no tension right now between Team Sanders and the DNC?
No.
All right, so we were watching the Jeff Zeleny piece. We were sitting here together. Our viewers, you were watching it. A spokeswoman for your husband's campaign appeared in it, Brianna Joy Gray, and she said she misspoke when she said that Bloomberg had a heart attack. And just to be clear, in fact, he did not have a heart attack. But it is the second time in 2 days that she has said she has misspoke when it comes to Michael Bloomberg. Are you concerned that these statements, which are quite damaging to another candidate, are hurtful to your campaign as well?
Well, we certainly don't like any attacks on other candidates from our campaign. We don't, I think she misspoke. She had the wrong information. She apologized right away. And I think that, I mean, what more can we do? Everybody makes mistakes.
So what is your advice to your husband tonight? You're out here with me. What does he do right before the debate?
Be himself. Let the people know what he stands for, as I think they already do. I think that's why he's at the top of the polls, that he is seen as somebody who's consistent and somebody they can trust. They know that he has always and will always stand up for the working families of America, and that he's the candidate that can beat Trump. Demonstrate that, show who he is, and I think he'll do fine.
All right, Jane, thank you very much. Good to
thank
see you.
You.